In this example, we're given a fax machine and we're asked what's the minimum time to send a single page over a particular telephone channel. And we're given some information about the telephone channel. So we're told that the bandwidth is 3 kHz. We're given the maximum signal to noise ratio, 30 decibels. We're told that the picture has this many picture elements or pixels or dots, and we're told how many gray levels there are, so how many shades of gray, or how many levels our quantizer will have. So this is essentially a channel capacity question. Because it's asking for a minimum time, it's like asking for the channel capacity. So remember the Shannon-Harley law that gives us the relationship between the channel capacity, the bandwidth, and the signal-to-noise ratio. So the signal-to-noise ratio is 30 decibels, but not quite. We still need to calculate it as a ratio. All right, so that's the first thing. We need the bandwidth. The bandwidth is given there. And eventually, we need to use the channel capacity to find the time. So let's take this step by step. So the signal to noise ratio in decibels is 10 log to the base 10, the signal to noise ratio as a unitless power ratio. So S over N is 10 to the power SNR divided by 10. So that's 10 divided 10 to the power 3, which is 1,000. So that 1,000 goes in there. So the channel capacity is simply 3,000 times log to the base 2. It's very important that you use the base 2 rather than the base 10 into 1,001. And putting that in your calculator, that gives you 29901.7. And the units is bits per second. So channel capacity is how fast we can send data through the channel. So the unit is bits per second, so it's like saying how much data in bits can we send per unit time in seconds. And the question's asking for time, so we can rewrite time as the amount of data we have divided by C. The amount of data is the number of pixels, the number of dots, times the number of bits per pixel. And we're given the number of pixels, the number of dots, and N here, it's not 12. It's log 12 to the base 2. Now we're not going to take the closest integer to that, or the next highest integer. We're not going to apply the ceiling function. What we're going to do is just use it as log 12 because we're looking for the minimum time. So we're looking at a theoretical limit. So we're allowed to simply say log 2 of 12. And then we divide that by the 29901.7. And that gives you a number in seconds. And if you divide by 60, it gives you approximately 4.5 minutes. So that's the final answer for that. I hope you found that easy to follow.